Jon Cohen, partner at Nexlaw. Today we're talking about the new stunt driving laws in Ontario, part two, the 30-day suspension. The 30-day license suspension is now active, and if you've been charged as of around July 13, 2021, then you are now receiving an instant roadside suspension for 30 days, along with that 14-day car impound. And the new Mums Act, Moving Ontario's More Safely Act, now includes this 30-day roadside suspension when you are charged with stunt driving or racing in Ontario under Section 172.1 of the Highway Traffic Act. And this means that if you speed at 50 kilometers per hour or more above the posted speed limit in an 80 kilometer per hour or higher zone, or if you are 40 kilometers per hour in a zone lower than 80 kilometers per hour, you will immediately get this 30-day administrative license suspension at the scene of the charge. So what happens now? With your immediate suspension, you will have to have someone pick you up at the scene of the charge. This means that you will have to arrange for a family member, an Uber, or another mode of transportation to pick you up at the roadside. Because with a license suspension for 30 days, you cannot sit behind the wheel of a car legally for at least these 30 days, or you risk even further, more serious charges. The officer has a lot of power, yes. They act as judge and jury. So the stunt driving laws in Ontario give the officer the power to charge you and therefore enact the suspension and impound without what would normally be a due process. Normally, unless you've been convicted in court, your Ontario stunt driving or racing charge is an allegation that is not yet proven. However, at the roadside, the officer is empowered to initiate these pre-conviction penalties, license suspension and car impound. So here's a question. How can I be suspended if I haven't even seen the radar? Well, what if I dispute the charge? Well, because stunt driving is considered a public safety offense, the lawmakers in Ottawa have decided that regardless of the outcome of the case, you need to cool down at the roadside and you need to take this 30-day break from driving with the form of a license suspension. And the car impound helps to send this message along with the license suspension. So if I fight my stunt driving ticket and it gets dismissed or some other outcome other than stunt driving, can I get back the impound fees or loss of income from the 30-day suspension? And unfortunately, the answer is no. The law is very specific and there is no recourse to recoup these losses through the provincial court system where your charges are being heard. The easiest way to think of this process is in three parts. So part one, there's the pre-court phase. And this is the roadside charge where you get the impound and the 30-day license suspension. This happens before your charges, and this portion of your charge is not directly related to the court process itself in phase two. Phase two, the court phase. This is where you have to defend yourself in court from the actual charge of stunt driving or racing in Ontario, and the fact that you were suspended and the car was impounded are not defenses or arguable at this phase of your charges. So the relevant facts here are the radar reading, the speed, etc. So this portion of this phase is to prove innocence or guilt. And then thirdly, there is the post-court phase. And these are the penalties that take place after the court process or not, if the case is dismissed. And this would involve further license suspension, fines, G2 penalties, MTO issues, etc. So how do I arrange to get my license back? And that's the good news here is that you have received a 30-day administrative suspension. This means that your license is automatically reinstated after that 30 days. However, we always suggest to be proactive and always call the MTO a few days before the 30 days to double check that the license is actually been or being reinstated. So here's some helpful links. If you look at the description of this video, you can call Service Ontario, double check with them. There's a driver's license suspension check to double check if you're actually suspended. So what are my next steps after I get back my Ontario driver's license? Well, the 30-day suspension was just the beginning. Now you have to deal with your actual charges in court, and a stunt driving conviction can have serious penalties such as a mandatory 1 to 3 year license suspension, which is part of the Mums Act, up to $10,000 in fines, up to 6 months in jail. And these are penalties that will impair your ability to work and to drive and to function. These are the penalties that will have a serious impact on your civil liberties. And these are the penalties that you need to be focused on now. These penalties themselves should be enough reason to get legal advice and a strategy that will keep you driving in Ontario.